Hey family, what's going on? Klaus here, and thank you for tuning into our Town Hall 9 Let's Play, and today we are going to be attempting a low-level queen walk with level 3 healers, guys. So we got a level 13 queen, and we don't have a max level 4 healer, or actually level 5 is max, but level 4 would be max for Town Hall 9, and it's going to be a struggle, guys, but we're going to try it because I know there's a lot of you guys out there that would love to see if this can be done and how to do it if it's possible. So, again, guys, we got level 3 healers, level 4 is max for Town Hall 9. I've got 5 because I'm thinking, you know, seeking air mines or, you know, the fact that level 3 healers aren't as good. We got an extra healer. I've also got a whole bunch of giants for tanking and archers for funneling purposes, and then obviously a bunch of wall breakers to help our queen get in there and get that dark elixir. Guys, I've got 2 jump spells, a rage and a heal. Actually, I think 2 rages would be better. We want 2 rages. We don't want 2 jumps, so we'll go ahead and get ourselves another rage spell. So now we get 2 rage spells, a jump and a heal, and I've got my clan castle of giants, guys, with the clan castle poison spell. Let's go out and let's find us some loot with this baby queen walk. All right, guys, here's a great example of a base that I'm very curious to see if we can queen walk, because it's got these level 3 expos, okay? These level 3 expos are crazy strong. Fortunately for us, this queen is only level 10, and we've got an upgrading sweeper, which should really help our cause, as obviously the sweepers and the healers don't get along very well. So let's come at this base from the backside of this sweeper over here, and let's put the queen on the, directly in line with this air defense, okay? So I've got my queen down, I got my healer down, and then I'm gonna put down a few giants and a few archers. I'm gonna funnel out the bottom, that way we know that the queen will go up and into the base. We want to go directly at that air defense there, and we also want to get that queen to go in and get that dark elixir. That's obviously the main purpose for why we're here. So we'll put down another giant just to make sure we get a good funnel put into place. The queen takes care of that archer tower very nicely, guys. If we can make sure we get this, oh man, we need this elixir storage to go down quick. Come on, queen, don't you turn. Okay, good, we're good to go. All right, now we need to break her in, so let's see. Let's put a distracting giant down. Let's also put down some wall breakers, and we need a couple more giants. We need to break the queen in very nicely. All right, so the queen is in. Let's drop this rage spell because we are now in line of this air defense, and it starts shooting our healers. We are good to go, guys. It looks like everything is going according to plan. Our queen is in, which is crazy. We need a clan castle of giants as well. These are max giants, so that should help a lot. And then let's put down our archers really nicely out here on the outside just to make sure we get a nice funnel set up. All right, guys, so we got one more rage spell. So far, this baby queen walk with 5 level 3 healers is working just fine. But I'm curious to see if we can jump her in and maybe do some more damage, okay? So I've got my healers, actually my wall breakers. Let's put some wall breakers down. Let's poison spell the enemy queen. That should help us get through that wall. Very nice. All right, so we're into that wall as well. Let's put our king. Where do we want our king, guys? Let's put our king on the enemy king, and then we'll lay down a whole nice massive arches on that side as well. So the queen is having to deal with the enemy queen and took her out, guys. We're having some great luck here. Let me pop the king's ability because it didn't look like he was doing so good. Now, guys, everything is looking very nice. What do you think? We only have a minute left, so we should probably rage the queen. Let's just drop the rage on the queen just to get her that extra DPS and see if we can maybe get some more of the loot. We got all the dark elixir out of the storage. We just took out the town hall. The only dark elixir we're missing now is either in the clan castle or this little level 1 drill back here, so that's no big deal. Queen is getting destroyed right now. We're gonna need her special ability right now. Oh man, that was clutch. And we have a heal spell as well. Doesn't look like we're gonna need it. Let's jump the queen this direction, because all the storages that we need to get are up here on the top. So if she decides to take it or not, that's not a really big deal. She is doing some work right now, guys. That expo, oh man, this, look at that. Oh, and seeking air mine. This Tesla and this expo are doing some crazy work on us right now, guys. And she decides to go for that mortar as well. So the queen does not get all the way through the base, but we did get a great 60% 2-star against a pretty solid base. I mean, not a weak base, with only level 3 healers and a level 13 queen. So is a level 13 queen walk possible, guys? I think so. In fact, that was more of a queen charge than a queen walk, and it was successful. So very nice. Loot grab was good at 220,000 gold, a bunch of 426,000 elixir, and over 2,700 dark elixir. And what I love about this army composition is that it costs 0 dark elixir. So all of that was profit, guys. A beautiful raid. Let's go out and let's do another. Oh my goodness, guys, the first search in this guy, Azen Gray Nicole, nice name, is a dead 10-09 with 3,400 Dark Clicks. So this was a lucky find, guys, and I've got the exact same army composition I had a minute ago with one jump spell, heal spell, two rages. I'm ready to go. I don't have a Clan Castle of Giants this time, though, unfortunately, but it's just gonna have to be all right. So where are the sweepers? That's the main thing. The sweepers are there. So let's start the queen kind of behind that sweeper there and start her way up here on the top. Let's put our healers down nice and early. Let's also put down a giant or two and funnel out these buildings way out here on the side, just to make sure that the queen does not go to the right, because then that air defense is going to shoot down our healers. So the giants are doing some nice tanking right now. We need both of those builder huts to go down. There we go. Awesome. Okay, so I think we're good to go. I would love to see the queen skirt this base, take out this air defense because it is within her range, and then also take out the enemy queen. I've got a raid spell ready to go. She's going to get rid of this elixir storage, and then she's going to step up. She's going to go for this air defense and then keep walking down the base here. Like I said, I've got a rage spell ready in case she really... Actually, I think we're going to need the rage. All right, so the rage spell is down. I got my ability ready as well. Queen, why aren't you going for this air defense? Okay, we're going to get the air defense. That's perfect. Let's get our poison spell ready for the enemy queen. All right, so we got a rage spell on the queen, a poison on the enemy queen. That is perfect. All right, you got to be very quick, very early with these rage spells and poison spells, guys, if you want to keep a low-level queen walk alive. So we're doing well so far, guys. The queen is going to grab this air defense, and then that's perfect. All right, so the next step is let's put our giants ahead. We're going to put our giants way up here. We're going to funnel in front of the queen to get our queen to go into the base. So that's perfect. Let's get our wall breakers in as well. Watch queen's health while you're doing this kind of thing. Wall breakers to get the king in. Wall breakers to get the giants in. Archers behind. We got four more wall breakers, actually. So we'll see if maybe we can get in a little bit deeper. I don't know. We'll see. Let's see. King is struggling right now. Let's pop his ability. Let's also get some archers going in real nice and strong here. And let's actually heal spell those archers because this the wizard tower. Oh, the wizard tower is one-shotting our archers. That's not cool, man. That was just not cool. But we survived it. So now our queen walk's still alive. We've got a rage spell for the core. Looking very nice. Where's all of our dark elixir? Actually, we've got a ton of loot on the outside. I doubt we're going to get all the loot because the fact is we had a lot of loot in the storages. But we also had a ton of loot in the collectors in the mines, and because our queen is so weak right now, she's not able to get into and clear the entire base like a typical max queen would with this Boston special. So we should have held on to a few archers and sniped some of that loot, but it's going to be fine. It's just going to have to be fine. Now, the middle has a ton of HP, so let's go ahead and raid spell that, and also that sweeper might cause some problems. I got a jump spell. Let's go ahead and just jump over this little retaining wall here, just because I didn't want her to have to deal with that little nook. She should get that town hall, and then at about 10 seconds left, we'll go ahead and use your special ability just because we can, and that should help us get all of that, all this high HP buildings here in the middle here. So let's use our ability. Actually, let's hold on to our ability because we're about to have to deal with the sweeper without a rage spell. So that is unfortunate, but we are getting that dark elixir storage, which was exactly what we wanted. Let me pop the queen's ability for the last 5 seconds, and then we will close out with a queen fully intact, guys. We missed out on that dark elixir drill and a few, some loot on the outside, but still, guys, I think we're proving our point that the queen walk is totally viable at level 13, which I didn't expect. I was kind of like, oh, this is going to be a fail montage, but things are going really, really well, and using five of these sub-max healers is working out great, guys. Let's go out and do one more raid, go for maybe a three-star if we can, but we'll just have to work within the confines of the limitations of our troops. So let's go find one more base. All right, guys, here's a good base that we're going to hit Blaziken, and he is sitting on 2,700 Dark Elixir, which I happen to know is almost entirely in the storage in the middle, and I guarantee you that this whole thing is surrounded by giant bombs and Teslas. We've got a sweeper pointing down to the right and another sweeper pointing up to the left, so let's go at this base directly at the queen. Also, I only have four healers. I'm going to try it out and see if four healers is enough to get us the dark elixir in the core. That is the goal. That is the question. All right. Now, again, we don't have clan castle troops, but that shouldn't be a big deal. Let's see how this queen walk works, guys. We are going to send her right out the corner. Let's see. Can we get... Yes, we can get in through this corner. Let's get in there. Yes. All right. So the wall's broken up already. And what we're going to do is we're definitely going to prioritize taking out the enemy queen. So we have our rage spell ready. But we also want to make sure that we take out an air defense, but we'll get one either way, whichever direction we go. Let's pop the ability of the queen. There we go. We got rid of a point defense and the enemy queen using that special ability, so that was really well used. And now, guys, what we're going to do is we're going to respond to the direction she goes. I know she will take out that sweeper, and if she does, then it's no big deal. It doesn't matter which way she goes, as long as we put our troops, like our king, our giants, our archers, everything in front of the queen so that she funnels in toward the core. That's what we want. So, and normally we do that at a 90 degree angle. I'll explain what that means in just a moment. So the queen walk is in. We got, again, four healers, not five, just to see how it goes. So far, it's working really well. We already used our special ability. Look at that, guys. 1 point defense, and the healers are keeping up for the most part. They might be losing the battle just a bit. I'm not entirely sure. Looks like we got a clan castle, so that is not good. I'm going to drop the rage spell. We got Valkyries, guys. Poison spell on the Valkyries. And oh my goodness, guys, we might not survive this. Oh man, those Valkyries are OP. Okay, we made it. All right. Wow, that was scary. All right, so the queen looks like she's wanting to go north. That's fine. Okay, so she's on the top right-hand side, so we're going to send the giants and the king and everything right up here at the top. Let's put some archers really strong up here. Oh, the queen. Oh, the queen. Oh, no, don't die. Oh, the queen didn't make it. Oh, that's not good, guys. That is just not good at all. I got two jump spells remaining, so I guess I could potentially get my troops in. That is just unfortunate for us, guys. The queen died. All right, well, I guess we needed five healers. That kind of proves the point, I guess. But the good thing is that our king should, based on what I'm seeing here, should go into the core. So that's good news. Let me put the archers real thick and heavy behind the king. And actually, we have, oh wow, guys, we have got a giant walk going into the core. We got our kings and tons of archers as well that should be able to get in and take out the dark elixir in the core. So let's just see this happen, guys. King's ability, real nice and early. Unfortunately, our healers are dead. The king is getting oh, come on, get that town hall. At least get the town hall. All right, so we got the town hall. Will we get that dark elixir storage? No, I don't think so. We're about to run out of time. Oh, man. All right, well, Blaziken saved his dark elixir. That was nice. But it looks like, based on the two successful raids at the beginning and then this third fail, you really do need five healers if you're going to be going after, like, max 10 or 9 bases like that one with a lower queen and with lower healers. If you get level 4 healers, then you probably can get away with only using 4. And obviously, having a stronger queen is always a better plan. So, I'm going to finish up this boost, guys. I'm going to spend some loot today, and then we're going to call it a day. So, I'll be back with you guys in just a second. Alright guys, I'm back, the boost is over, and I got a pretty good amount of loot that I get to spend today, so let's go into my progress base. Had an absolute blast finishing that one off, but just took a break from the lights and the camera. Now guys, we're ready to go. I've got one builder remaining. I've got two builders actually finishing up tomorrow, so I'll probably do some more raiding tomorrow, but what I am going to upgrade today is a lot of walls. That's what I'm going to focus on today. Also guys, we've got 3 days left in the laboratory before we have the witches, before the witches are done, and then I'll likely get the healers going, because as you saw, healers make a difference. So we're definitely gonna upgrade those in 3 days, but right now I can spend every single drop of my loot on walls, and then we're gonna upgrade the queen to level 14. That's 70,000 dark elixir, and I'm sitting on 101,000, so that is wonderful. Plus, I have some loot in the treasury, guys. Let's go ahead and collect that there. Very nice. Okay, so what that does is we can do 5 walls with gold. So let's go ahead and count that out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that should be 5 million gold there. Yes, okay, let's do 5 million gold in walls in 3, 2, 1, bam! Oh man, alright, and then the next step, guys, is let's do the rest of the walls and upgrades with elixir. So we get 3 million elixir, no, select all, there we go. Let's do 3 million elixir, guys, getting these walls done. That's 5 and 3, that's 8 million loot on walls today in 3, 2, 1, bam! Nice, alright, now, we've got all of our walls done, and like I said, I've only got one builder remaining right now, so let's go ahead and get the priority done and started, guys. Getting this queen to level 15 is our number one priority right now, besides obviously keeping this laboratory going. So let's upgrade the queen, guys, going to level 14. That's a 70,000 dark elixir upgrade, 6.5 days. Oh my goodness, let's get this going in 3, 2, 1, bam! All right, guys, and we still have 34,000 dark elixir remaining so that we can continue adding on to maybe put the Barbarian King down soon, or once the queen wakes up at 14, put her down to 15 with 75,000 Dark Elixir. But guys, that is it for today. Hope you enjoyed checking out some low-level queen walk action. Obviously, seeing progress on the base, getting tons of walls done, guys. It was an absolute blast. Hope you enjoyed it. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe if you're not joined the Colossus family. And as always, guys, I will see y'all again next time.